Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Almighty God, to all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Merciful God, who sent your messengers, the prophets, to preach repentance and prepare the way for our salvation, give us grace to heed their warnings and forsake our sins, that we may greet with joy the coming of Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Baruch. Take off the garment of your sorrow and affliction, O Jerusalem, and put on forever the beauty of the glory from God. Put on the robe of the righteousness that comes from God. Put on your head the diadem of the glory of the everlasting, for God will show your splendor everywhere under the heavens. For God will give you evermore the name Righteous Peace, Godly Glory. Arise, O Jerusalem, stand upon the height, look towards the east, and see your children gathered from west and east at the word of the Holy One, rejoicing that God has remembered them. For they went out from you on foot, led away by their enemies. But God will bring them back to you, carried in glory as on a royal throne. For God has ordered that every high mountain and the everlasting hills be made low, and the valleys filled up to make level ground, so that Israel may walk safely in the glory of God. The woods and every fragrant tree have shaded Israel at God's command, for God will lead Israel with joy in the light of his glory, with the mercy and righteousness that come from him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Philippians. I thank my God every time I remember you, constantly praying with joy in every one of my prayers for all of you, because of your sharing in the gospel from the first day until now. I am confident of this, that the one who began a good work among you will bring it to completion by the day of Jesus Christ. It is right for me to think this way about all of you because you hold me in your heart, for all of you share in God's grace with me, both in my imprisonment and in the defense and confirmation of the gospel. For God is my witness, how I long for all of you with the compassion of Christ Jesus. And this is my prayer, that your love may overflow more and more with knowledge and full insight to help you determine what is best, so that on the day of Christ you may be pure and blameless, having produced the harvest of righteousness that comes through Christ Jesus for the glory and praise of God. The word of the Lord.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke. In the 15th year of the reign of Emperor Tiberius, when Pontius Pilate was governor of Judea, and Herod was ruler of Galilee, and his brother Philip ruler of the region of Iturea, and Trachonitis and Lysanias ruler of Abilene, during the high priesthood of Annas and Caiaphas, the word of God came to John, son of Zechariah, in the wilderness. He went into all the region around the Jordan, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. As it is written in the book of the words of the prophet Isaiah, the voice of one crying out in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make his paths straight. Every valley shall be filled, and every mountain and hill shall be made low, and the crooked shall be made straight, and the rough ways made smooth, and all flesh shall see the salvation of God. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise Shine on us, gracious God, and guide our feet into the way of peace. Amen. We chose words very carefully at Children's Hospital as we crafted a memorial service to which families could come and where staff could gather to remember children they had cared for. We chose those words very carefully for people whose grief was fresh and raw, who had struggled to find any sense at all or meaning in a world where everything was turned upside down. We chose those words carefully for people who had poured out their hearts and souls and skills and wisdom in caring and comforting and working their hardest for the lives of children. In addition to a beautiful passage from The Velveteen Rabbit and a lovely story of transformation that relied heavily on water bugs and dragonflies, we looked for what words of faith could possibly be spoken in that moment. What words would be authentic and real and genuine and believable and reliable in such a difficult time? And the words, among the words we settled on, are words from the canticle this morning, from the Song of Zechariah. The words are these: "In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace." These words may resonate for us in a time when many things seem to have been turned upside down, when loss is a consistent theme, and when meaning and hope sometimes feel far away from us as well. Words that we can carry with us, hang on to, and rely on as real and genuine in the midst of our own questioning and wondering and doubting about the presence of God in the midst of things. Zechariah, who speaks these words in Luke's gospel, had his own difficulty in believing or imagining that this could be true. When the angel Gabriel comes to him to announce that Elizabeth will bear a child and they will become parents in their old age and that the child will have a special purpose, Zechariah's response is, "How will I know that this is so? I'm old, my wife is old, why should I believe this?" And so the angel Gabriel, hearing this response from Zechariah, silences him until the things occur. And so through the entire time of Elizabeth's pregnancy and presumably the 8 days up until the circumcision, Zechariah says nothing. So are the words we hear today carefully chosen words? Did he spend that 9 months and 8 days carefully crafting the song that he would sing to celebrate the birth of this child? Or are they words carefully chosen and crafted because of his deep faith in the expectations and hopes of the people of Israel? Because in his life, in his prayer, in his service as a priest, he has internalized those hopes and expectations, sees the prophetic vision and the expectation of God's presence with God's people. Carefully chosen words, words that are among the three great songs in this first part of Luke's gospel, all of which have been imprinted and taken hold in the prayers of the church. The Song of Mary, the Magnificat, the Song of Simeon, the Nunc Dimittis, and this Song of Zechariah, the Benedictus, which have taken hold and taken root in the words we pray. They are words of hope and promise. They are words that show the breadth of what God's promise for the fulfillment of creation will look like. With everyone gathered, everyone, all flesh, will see the salvation of God. They hold the sense of forgiveness and salvation. And as Zechariah narrows down from his overflowing blessing and praise of God to capture the mission and the call of his son John, he ultimately comes to these words, the tender compassion of God shining on those who dwell in darkness and guiding us into the way of peace. Distilling down to things that are authentic, real, and reliable as we anticipate the coming of Jesus into the world. God's tender compassion, drawing near to everyone, moved deeply by human need and suffering, wanting to restore all things in creation to their intended life and glory. The dawn breaking. Most of us these days are awake when dawn comes in the winter months. We know that very, very tentative beginning of daylight, whether we see a horizon and see the light appear just above it, or whether we watch the gradual opening up of the blueness of the sky as light begins to dawn, we see that very early beginning of light. Not yet the brightness of the noonday sun, for at least a couple days a year in Pittsburgh, but the light that reassures us, the light that comes day after day after day to dispel the darkness, to take away the shadows and the fear of night, and to remind us again and again and again of the presence and the promise and the light of God, a light that shines even where people dwell in darkness and in the shadow of death. We see that tender dawn, that gentle coming of light to fill us with hope. We know that the destination of this road is peace. Peace from the questioning and concern of our life. Peace from the chaos and the wielding of power which is all around us. Peace as the goal of all of our striving and working to help to establish God's kingdom on earth. Peace a destination we all long for. The roads will be made straight and level so that all creation, all people, can come streaming toward that light, finding that way of peace. In these simple words and images, we find things that are authentic and reliable and true. These are words for us to hold close in this season of Advent as we watch and wait for the coming of Jesus. Words to hold close as we watch and wait for the coming of peace. Amen.
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us and for our salvation. He came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
Let us pray that Emmanuel will come to us. For the Church, for the Anglican Communion, and for Justin, Archbishop of Canterbury. For the Episcopal Church and for Michael, our presiding bishop. For the Diocese of Pittsburgh and for Ketlin, our bishop. For those receiving gifts through the East End Cooperative Ministry Berry Project. For all who seek forgiveness of sins and the hope of salvation. Fill your people with knowledge and insight, and let love overflow among us. Come, O come, Emmanuel. Come and save us. For this community, the nation, and the world, for people working for racial justice and equity, for public health officials and healthcare workers, for wisdom in dealing with the new COVID variant, for the Supreme Court of the United States, for migrants and refugees, and for all people seeking a home, for those who serve our country, particularly Christine, Wade, Trace, Robert, John, and Chris, for their families and for the safe return of those far from home. Strengthen us to prepare the way for righteousness, mercy, and peace. Come, O come, Emmanuel, come and guide us. For those who are troubled or fearful, for Elise, Diane, Benjamin, Bob, Henry, Tim, Bob, Erica, Margaret, Stefan, Linda, Paulette, Charles, Anne Marie, Paul, Murray, Paula, Larry, Maggie, Don, Clint, Marianne, Mary, Phyllis, Alan, Bill, Molly and her family, Kitsy, Walter, Doreen, Susie, Ray, Adam, Marianne, and all those who have been commended to our prayers. For people infected with COVID-19, for people throughout the world living with HIV and AIDS, for those struggling with addiction and those in recovery, for caregivers, for those whom we now name. Let the dawn of your compassion break upon them. Come, O come, Emmanuel, come and heal us. For those who have died, for Ronald Mazur, for those in whose memory altar flowers are given today, Janet Ackerman, Norman Ernst, Ronald Mazur, Jesse Watson, May Watson, Robert Watson, Charles Watson, Laura Wright, and Merrill Wright. For people who have died from COVID-19, and for their loved ones, for all victims of gun violence, for those who mourn, for those whom we now remember. Shine on those who dwell in darkness and in shadow of death. Come, O come, Emmanuel, come.
Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you, and also with you.
Welcome, everyone, to Calvary Church in Pittsburgh this morning. It's great to have you with us either in person or online. A few things to note. This evening at 5:00, there will be the service of lessons and carols for Advent. This is a wonderful opportunity to be surrounded by music and scripture and to reflect and find a moment of peace in the midst of preparing for Christmas. So please think about giving yourself the gift of Advent lessons and carols. The Calvary Christmas pageant will happen on December 19th, and you will see details in the bulletin about how to participate or help with that project. The young adults will have an Advent party on Thursday, the 16th of this month. So please check in with Neil about that Advent celebration. In addition to being in the Advent season, we are also in the stewardship season. We are grateful for everyone who has already pledged financial support to Calvary for the coming year, and we invite everyone who has not yet had that opportunity to do it. This parish has been remarkably steadfast and generous through these past years, and we look forward to moving through 2022 with that strength as well. So thank you. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, because you sent your beloved Son to redeem us from sin and death, and to make us heirs in him of everlasting life. That when he shall come again in power and great triumph to judge the world, we may without shame or fear rejoice to behold his appearing. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. We give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you made known to us in creation, and the calling of Israel to be your people, and your words spoken through the prophets, and above all, in the Word made flesh, Jesus your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he'd given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he'd given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory. And we offer a sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection unto your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country, where with John the Baptizer, the ever-blessed Virgin Mary, and all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters, through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him, and with him, and in him, the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. The gifts of God for the people of God. Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we thank you for feeding us with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and for assuring us in these holy mysteries that we are living members of the body of your Son and heirs of your eternal kingdom. And now, Father, send us out to do the work you have given us to do, to love and serve you as faithful witnesses of Christ our Lord. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit be honor and glory, now and forever. The peace of God that passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of God's Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always. Amen.
Christ.